When fitting this wagon with new brakes, I'm going to adapt this old brake lever and brake roller to fit. The lever itself is too long, and the roller, which actually activates the brake bar, is 2 inches too short. So I'm going to go ahead and make some modifications on this iron. Once I have this brake roller modified, I went ahead and made some brackets that's going to mount it to the underneath side of the reach hounds. But in doing the modifications, even though it's ground out, you can tell there's a difference between the old iron and new iron. So I'm going to put it in the forge, bring it up to heat, and kind of distress it to make it look like it is all one unique piece of iron. With this done, then it doesn't look like the repairs are quite so obvious. Now that this fits a little more correctly, I need a rod to connect the brake roller lever to the brake handle. And again, I'm going to adapt this old iron to make it work. These brake rod ends come pre-drilled and tapped for 3/8 rod. I'm going to open it up for this 9/16. In fitting it up to make sure it works, I'm just going to put some hex bolts in. Eventually, I'll make these all square-headed bolts. Now I need the brake hanger and the brake bar, and all the iron that makes it work. These new castings will hold the brake blocks, sometimes called the brake clutch. Then I need the draw rod that connects the brake roller to the brake bar. Now these brake shoes or brake clutches are tapered two directions, so it requires a tapered dovetail on the brake block in order to fit these. I started thinking this one was 2, but it ends up being 1.5 degrees, and this one was about 6, so I'll set my table for 6. Now each of these brake blocks will get a metal face that will rub up against the rubber tire, which is the best braking coefficient. Thanks again for watching.